Hello everyone, I am Gaurav Gupta, Azure Mathematics teacher. Today we will discuss our fourth chapter, exercise 4.2. This is our second lecture on chapter 2. In first lecture, we already studied what is determinants and how we calculate the determinants of either order 2 into 2 or 3 into 3. As well as we already studied how we calculate the minor cofactors and what is your singular matrix as well as non-singular matrix. But this exercise 4.2, it's very important for your examination point because this exercise carry 4 marks question or 6 marks question depending upon the your board. In CBSE board or other boards like Haryana board, Maharashtra board, UP boards, one question must be put in your final exam, either to 4 marks or 6 marks according to weightage criteria. So this exercise is very long and we have all the question like proving question, not we have to evaluate type question. In this exercise we did how to prove determinant based question. So such type of exercise, how we can proceed, we have to follow some rules or we have to follow or to know about the different properties of the determinants. So in this lecture we take one by one each property with example so that you understand its base and how you can utilize or use the property to prove the different determinant based question. If you know the property, if you clear your concept according to your property understanding, if you know the each property, then it's very easy to prove such a question. But if you don't understand the properties, then this exercise becomes very difficult. So I request to everyone, please watch this video carefully and try to understand each property very carefully. So before to start the video, I request to everyone, if still someone not subscribe my channel, and if you realize such video will really help you and will help in your final exam to crack your final exam or to clear the concept to crack the your competitive exam, then do subscribe my channel. So let's we process or proceed to our properties of the determinants. We take one by one. Please make a note. So our first property, it says the value of the determinants, the value of the determinants remains unchanged if its row are changed into column or column into row. It means if you take the transpose of the matrix and then calculate the determinants, that determinants will be same as before taking the transpose of the matrix. So determinants of A must be equal to determinant of transpose of the matrix A. Now I am going to take an example. Please look. Let A matrix I take a matrix A 2, 3, 4, 5 and I have to calculate its determinants. Then A determinants is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, which is equal to, it's basically 2 cross 2. So we have to calculate forward cross product minus reverse cross product. So 2 into 5, which is equal to 10, minus reverse cross product 3 into 4, 12, which is equal to minus 2. This is your determinants. In this case we get the determinants is equal to minus 2. Now we have to analyze its right hand side. Now firstly we have to take the transpose, and we know transpose means to change the row into column or change column into row. Because if we do one, then automatically we have to get second one. If we change row into column, then naturally column will change into row. So now we have to take its transpose. Here this is your A matrix, and we have to calculate A transpose. So in this we take the transpose row into change into column. So we get 2, 3. Now this one is your 4, 5. We get 4. So we change row into column, and we get the matrix which is transpose of A. Now we have to take its determinant. Then what will be the statement? 2, 4, 3 and 5. Again I revise, please keep in mind matrix is represented by square brackets, but determinant is represented by parallel lines, because matrices and determinants are something different, and the rules to process this are also different. So make keep a note. 2 into 5 which is equal to 10 minus 4 into 3 is equal to 12. We get minus 2. It means here also we get minus 2, and here we also get minus 2. It means left hand side is equal to right hand side. So again I revise, if we change row into column or column into row, it means if we change or if we do transpose of any matrix, then determinants will not be changed. This set by property 1. The value of the determinant remains unchanged if the row is changed into column and column changed into row. Please make a note first. So let's take out next property, which says if two rows or column, either you have to change row or column, but you have to change only one at a time. If we two row or two columns of determinants are changed, it means if we change two row, either any two row or two column, either row or column, but only one at a time, are interchanged. If we apply the operation on row, if we interchange two any row, then the sign of the determinant will change. How it is work? Now take an example. We have to calculate the determinants of A, 2, 3, 5, 6. We evaluate that determinants. What we will get? We get 6 into 2 which is equal to 12 minus 3 into 5 which is equal to 15, and we get negative 3. So now we apply the property. We change row, either to row, because this is the determinant of 2 into 2. So here we have only 2 row. But I have taken another example of what is 3 into 3 as well. So if I interchange two row, it means this one is your first row and this is your second row. Now I am going to interchange. So determinant becomes this row becomes first row. So this is R2 is your 5, 6, and 2, 3 becomes your first. So 5, 6, this is your second row, it becomes first. We interchange, then evaluate the determinant, which is equal to 5 into 3 is equal to 15, 2 into 6 is equal to 12, and we get 3. Compare this, sign is changed. Sign is changed. So this property says that if we interchange any two row or any two column, the sign of the recombinant will be changed. Such type of property is very helpful, and by using this property, we can prove the question of exercise 4.2. So please make a note. So now I am taking another example to show such property by taking an order of 3 cross 3. Let A matrix or determinant of A is equal to 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, and we have to calculate its determinant. As we already discussed, firstly we have to write, or we have now, we can expand it along any row or any column. But here I take to expand it along R1. R1 means this first positive, negative, and this one is your positive. Firstly, we have to write its element. It is 1, 2, 1. This sign is positive, this sign is negative, and this sign is positive. Now, make parallel lines. Now, calculate. If we remove this row and this column, what we will get? 1, 1, 1, 1. Now, if we remove second column and first row, what we will get? 3, 2, 1, 1. Now, if we remove our third column and first row, what we get? 3, 1, 2, 1. Now, expand it. 1, 1 into 1, 1, minus 1 into 1, 1. Negative 2. 3 into 1, 3, 1 into 2, 2, plus 1, 3 into 1, 3, minus 2 into 1, 2, which is equal to 1 minus 1, 0, minus 2 into 1, plus 3, 3 minus 2 is equal to 1, minus 2 plus 1, which is equal to minus 1. Now, interchange any two row or any two column. So, if I interchange first two rows, then what will be the determinants? We interchange this. We get 3, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1. Now, we have to calculate this. Firstly, we have to write its element. Now, this element is 3, 1, 1. This sign is positive, negative, positive. If we remove for first column and first row, what we will get? 2, 1, 1, 1. Now, remove second column, first row, we get 1, 2, 1, 1. Now, third column, first row, we get 1, 2, 2, 1. This will be 3, 2 into 1, 2, minus 1 into 1, 1. Negative 1, 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 2, 2, plus 1. 1 into 2, 1, 2 into 2, 4. 3, 2 in minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1 minus 2, minus 1, plus 1. Minus 3. 3 into 1, 3, minus minus, plus 1, and this will be minus 3. And 3 will be cancelled out with 3, we get plus 1. So, we cannot, in this, we get minus 1, and now we get plus 1. So, sign is changed. I hope this property will be clear to you. Please make a note. So now we proceed to our next property, which say if any two row or any two columns are identical, then their determinant will be 0. Again I repeat, if any two row, either R1 and R2, R1 and R3, R2 and R3, anyone. So if you found any two row or any two column are identical, then their determinant will equal to 0. Please take a look. For example,
if a determinant is equal to 2, 3, 2, 3. Now expanding 2 into 3, 6. 3 into 2, 6, which is equal to 0. Take another one example of order 3 into 3. Let 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 2, 1, 2, 1. In this, R1 is equal to R3. Now expanding along R1. Expand along R1. Firstly, write the elements 1, 2, 1. 1. I write here 1, 2, 1. 1, 2, 1. This is your positive, negative, positive. Now remove first row, first column. What you will get? 2, 2, 2, 1. Now remove second column, first row. You get 3, 1. 2, 1. Now remove third column, first row, you will get 3, 2, 1, 2. 3, 2, 1, 2. Now expand it 1, 2 into 1, 2, minus 2 into 2, 4, minus 2, 3 into 1, 3, minus 2 into 1, 2, plus 1, 3 into 2, 6, 2 into 1, 2, 1. 2 minus 4, minus 2, minus 2, 3 minus 2, which is equal to 1, plus 1, 6 minus 2 is equal to 4, minus 2, minus 2, plus 4, which is equal to 0. If you will found any two row or any two column, the determinant will be 0. Please make up now. Now I am going to take our next property, which say if any one row or column, if any one row or any one column is 0, then the determinant is equal to 0. I again repeat, if you found any one row or any one column is 0, the determinant will be 0. Please make a look. For example, if I have to find out the determinant of A, which is equal to 2, 3, 0, 0. Then what will be its determinant? 0 into 2, 0. Minus 3 into 0, 0. Which is equal to 0. You can take an example of 3 order 3. Which was 1, 2, 1. 2, 3, 2. 0, 0, 0. And we have to calculate its determinant. Firstly, have a 1, 2, 1. This sign is positive, negative, positive. Now, remove first row, first column, we get 3, 2, 0, 0. Second column, first row, we get 2, 2, 0, 0. If we remove third column, first row, we get 2, 3, 0, 0. 3 into 0, 0. 2 into 0, 0. Minus 2, 2 into 0, 0. 2 into 0, 0. Plus 1, 2 into 0, 0. 3 into 0, 0. It means 0, 0, 0. Answer is 0. Please make up now. So now I am going to take up next property, which is very important. And you must be understand this property, because without this property you cannot prove even 2, 3 or more than that questions. So please make a look very carefully. What it say? It say if each element in a row, it means we apply in a one row or in one column, if one row or one column is multiplied by a scalar number which is equal to the multiplication of that scalar number with the determinants. Again, I repeat, this read, if each element in a row or column
of a determinant is multiplied by the same factor, then the determinant is also multiplied by that factor. I take an example. Firstly, please look a multiplication of a scalar number with a matrix. How it is multiplied? If I take A is 2, 3, 4, 5, and we have to find 3A, it means we have to multiply 3 with each element of the matrix.
It means 3 multiply 2, 3, 4, 5, we get 6, 3 3 is a 9, 3 4 is a 12, and 3 5 is a 15. In matrix,
if we multiply a scalar number with a matrix, then the scalar number is multiplied by each element of the matrix. But in that case of determinant, it is not multiplied with each element of the determinant. It is multiplied either one row or any one columns. Please make a look. Let A determinant is 2, 3, 4, 5. This is your determinants. And we multiply if each element in a row or column. Now we have option either to apply in row or as well as in column. I am applying column. You can take any one. So if I multiply, I am going to multiply by a factor, multiply by 2, which column? C1. This is your first column. I am going to multiply by 2 of first column C1. It means I am going to take 2 into determinant of A. So 2 is not multiplied by each element, but it is multiplied either one row or one column, only one at a time. So 2 determinant is 2, 3, 4, 5, which is equal to, I am going to take multiply 2 to column 1. So 2 into 2, which is equal to 4. 2 into 4, 8. Not to each element, only first column. We get 3, 5. Now I am going to expand it and check the result, which is equal to 4 into 5, 20. Minus 8 into 3, 24, which is equal to minus 4. It said if each element I am in a row or a column, I take a column of a determinant is multiplied by the factor. Here factor is our 2. We get minus 4. Then the determinant is multiplied. It means this multiplication gives the same result as we multiply the factor by its determinant. Here A is determinant. If we expand it, 4 into 2, 10, 4 into 3, 12, we get minus 2. Then the determinant is, here determinant is minus 2. A determinant, you consider determinant is minus 2, and we multiply it by a factor of 2. Again, I repeat, this is your left hand side. Now we have to prove A determinant is minus 2, is multiplied by the factor. Factor is 2. Which is equal to minus 4, and the same answer is here. again I repeat, if the determinant is multiplied by any factor which gives the same result as we multiply that factor by any one row or any one column. So keep in mind K into A determinant is equal to K into A determinant. Here we multiply your factor K. K is a scalar number. Multiply by A. A means not we multiply only one row or one column. Not we have to take two rows. Here K is 1. Please make a note, then I will take more example of such property. So I have written K into determinant A whole determinant is equal to K into A determinant. But please make a note, here I multiply only one row. If you multiply the whole row, then this property will hold. K into A determinant is equal to K the whole power n. N is your order of the matrix. For example, I am going to take another example. Let K determinant is 2, 3, 6, 7. I am going to take an example. If we expand it, A determinant is 7 into 2, 14, minus 6 into 3, 18, we get 2. And if I multiply this by a factor, by a factor means firstly I write here 2, 3, 6, 7. Now I am going to multiply. In previous example I multiply with only one column. Now I am going to multiply with two columns. Means 2 into 2. 2 is multiplying with column C1. And next 2 is multiplied with column C. Then what will be its result? 2 into 2, 4, 6 into 2, 12, 3 into 2, 6, 7 into 2, 14. We get 14 into 4, 56, 12, 6, 72. We get an answer of 16 with sign. Negative. Are you getting my point? Now, here what we multiply? We multiply here is 4. Multiply 4. 4 means 2 into 2. 2 is multiplied with the first column and 2 is multiplied with the second column. Then the determinant will be multiplied by the same factor. Here factor we have used 2 into 2, then determinants is also multiplied by 2 into 2. 2 into 2 means 4 and determinant of A is 4. We get here minus 4. 4 into minus 4 which is equal to minus 16. The answer is 6. So please keep in mind, if we multiply any one column or any one row, we have to take any factor and that factor is multiplied either one row or one column. Here we have two factors, 2 into 2. So 2 is multiplied with first column and second 2 is multiplied with second column. It means we multiply a factor of 2 into 2. Then the determinant is also multiplied by the same factor 2 into 2 as a whole determinant. This will be your next property. And you can write in terms of this
k into a determinant which is equal to k whole power n into determinant of a. Here is we have to multiply k is 2, factor is 2, so 2a determinant will be equal to 2 and the order of the matrix is 2 into 2, so power is 2 and determinant of a is minus 4, we get minus 6. So please make a note, and this property is very important because one question of 1 marks is most probably put on this property based. Please make a note. So let's take our next property. What it say? If corresponding elements of any 2 row or 2 column, if any corresponding row or column of a determinants are proportional. I again repeat, if any 2 row or any 2 column correspondings are proportional. Proportional in the same ratio, then its value is again 0. Take an example. Let A determinant is 2, 3, 4, 6. If we evaluate by simple method, not use the property, then what will be its result? Which is equal to 2 into 6, which is equal to 12, minus 3 into 4, 12, is equal to 0. Plus, we have to look at its property. If any 2 row or any 2 column are corresponding or same proportional, then their determinant is 0. In this case, if we compare it, 2, 3, we can change it. 2 into 2. Now, this 6 can be written as 2 into 3. It means they are proportion. You can check in another way. This is your 2, 4, which is equal to 3, 5, 6. 1 by 2. 1 by 2, it means same proportion. So according to same proportion, their determinant is 0. You can do like in this manner. Now we have to take, or you can do by using another property. If you take common 2, taking common from this one is your second row and this one is your first row. I have take common 2 from row R. Taking common 2 from R2, then what will be the determinants? 2, 3, 2, 3, because these 2 come out as a common. Now compare this. R1 is equal to R2. And we already discussed our second property. If any 2 row or any 2 columns are same, then their determinant will also 0. In this case, R1 is equal to R2, so determinant is 0. Please make a note. So now I am taking our next property, which say if each elements of a row or column of a determinant is multiplied by the same factor, then the determinant is multiplied by that same factor. Again, I repeat,
if each element of any row, it means we have to apply either one row or any one column of a determinant, is multiplied by the same factor, then the determinant is multiplied by that factor. Please read. Sorry, we discussed such property already. Our next property is property 7 is, if each element of a row or column of a determinant is expressed as a sum of two or more terms, then the determinants can be expressed as a sum of two or more determinants. What it say? It say if any one row or any one column is expressed not as a single element, but it is in the form of sum of elements, like we have element 3, but it is not expressed as 3, it is expressed as 1 plus 2. So if any one row or any one column is expressed as sum of elements, then we can express the whole determinant as the sum of the determinants. How it works? Please make a loop. Example, if A determinant is equal to 1 plus 2, 3, 1, 2 plus 1, 2, 2, 3 plus 1, 1, 1. Here, column 1 is expressed as sum of elements, sum of elements. So we can express as sum of determinants. How we write the sum of determinants? Firstly, you have to write your first column. Here, first column becomes 1, 2, 3. And second column is same, 3, 2, 1. And third column is also same, 1, 2, 1. Plus, because we have to express sum of determinants. Plus, now we have to take second, 2, 1, 1. 2, 1, 1. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 1. 1, 2, 1. So, if we solve this, expand this, we get the same result. Please make a note. If we express it, how we express it? 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. 3, 1. 3, 2, 2. 3 plus 1, 4, 1, 1. Now we have to express it. Firstly, we have to write the elements. 3, 3, 1. This is your positive, negative, positive. Now, eliminate first row and first column, we get 2, 2, 1, 1. Second column, first row, we get 3, 4, 2, 1. Now, remove third column, first row, we get 3, 2, 4, 1. Now, solve it. 3, 2 into 1, 2, minus 2 into 1. Minus 3, 3 into 1, 3. Minus 4 into 2, 8. Plus 1, 3 into 1, 3. Minus 4 into 2, 8. Which is equal to 2 minus 2, 0. Minus 3, 3 minus 8, minus 5. Plus 3 minus 8, minus 5. We get minus 3 into minus 5, plus 15. Minus 5, which is equal to 10. Now we expand same. Please make a note first. So we get our left hand side is equal to 10. Now we expand our right hand side. Firstly, we expand this. What we get? 1, 3, 1. Positive, negative, positive. Now right, if we remove first row, first column, we get 2, 2, 1, 1. Second column, first row, we get 2, 3, 2, 1. Third column, first row, we get 2, 2, 3, 1. 1, 2 minus 2, minus 3,
2 into 1, 2 minus 6, plus 1, 2 into 1, 2 minus 8 to the 6. This is 0, minus 3, minus 4, plus 2 minus 6, which is equal to minus 4, minus 3 means plus 12, minus 4, which is equal to plus 8. Now expand this. Firstly, write the elements 2, 3, 1. Positive, negative, positive. Remove first row, first column, we get 2, 2, 1, 1. Second column, first row, we get 1, 1, 2, 1. Remove third column, first row, we get 1, 2, 1, 1. Now expand it. 2, 2 into 1, 2, minus 2, minus 3, 1 into 1, minus 2, plus 1, 1 into 1, minus 2. This is 0, minus 3, which is equal to minus 1, plus 1, minus 1. Minus 3 into minus 1, plus 3, minus 1, which is equal to 2. So here 8 plus 2, which is equal to 10. So left hand side, so your left hand side becomes equal to right hand side. So make a note first. So now I am going to discuss very important, this one is your last property, but not the least, it's very important properties. Please keep in mind and watch carefully, because such type of property as elementary operation we have to use in our next exercise also. So please look what it says. The value of a determinant is unaltered. It means the value of the determinant will not be changed. If each element of any row, if we select any one row or any one column, we add that row or column to add with multiple of k. K is a scalar number, but condition is that k never be equal to 0. The corresponding elements, it means first element corresponding to first, second with second, third corresponding to third of any other row. So firstly you look at, I am giving, take an example. Let firstly I take 2, 3, 5, 6. What will be the its determinant, which is equal to 6 into 2, 12, minus 5 into 3, 15, which is equal to minus 3. Now I have to choose any row, so I am choosing our first row, or I am choosing our first row. So you have to use symbol this. Whatever you choose a branch, either row or a column. I have choose here row 1, so I just write R1 and make it arrow. So I, any row, we add it. It means we have to add this row. This row. Some multiple of k, but k not equal to 0. Suppose I have take k is equal to 2. Let k is equal to 2. So 2 into of the corresponding element of any other row. If I choose row, then the corresponding element of other row. Now this here, because in this we have only 2 row, so I am choosing our second row R2. Then determinant will not change. So let's do process. Now we have to change, because we have applied an operation on R1. So the element of R1 will change. And what are the new elements of the R1? This will be according to that operation. How we get the elements? Firstly, our first element is 2. Now we have to change our new element. This one is your old, and this is your new. So old is your 2. Now new one is R1. 2, plus 2 into R2. R2 is corresponding to is 5. So we take 5. Now which one? 2 plus 2 into 5, 10. We get 12. It means we have to replace 2 by 12. Now take second element is 3. R1 is 3 plus 2 into R2. This corresponding 3 is 6. We get 3 plus 12, which is equal to 15. It means we have replaced 3 by 15. Now what we will get the determinants? Is replaced by 12, so we get here 12. 3 is replaced by 15, so we put 15. But R2 will not be changed. R2 will be same. 5, 6. Now solve it. 12 into 6, 72. Negative. 15 into 5. 75, which is equal to minus 3, and here we also get minus 3, and here we also get minus 3. Again I repeat, if any one row or any one column is added, here I take our row R1, I apply the operation on R1. So if R1 is added, we add this some multiple. I have taken multiple k is equal to 2 of the corresponding element of any other row. In this take, I have taken R2. So this is the your elementary operation. Such type of operation will help you to find the inverse in your next exercise. So in this is your old elements and this one is your new elements. So if we apply this, that determinant will be same, it will not be changed. So in this first we have take first element is 2, I have taken, then value of R1 is 2 and corresponding element of 2 is 5, so R2 is 5. 2 plus 5 into 2, 10, 12. Similarly I have take 3. 3. 3 is replaced by R1, 3 plus 2 into R2, 6. We get 15. It means old element is 2 and new element is 12. Old element is 3 and new element is 15. So we get a new determinant. 12, 15, 5 and 6. Now we solve this. 12 into 6, 72. 15 into 5, 75. We get minus 3. This minus 3 is equal to this minus 3. It means the value of the determinant is same. So I have complete my all these properties. If you like my video, so please do subscribe. And if you suggest me I have to improve some section, so comment me on my YouTube channel. Then I will take our next video on which we solve questions one by one from Element Mathematics Exercise 4.2. Please make a note.